Let's say now we don't have a single source of data, but for example, in this folder here, we've got five divisions, but they're five different CSV files. So we need to get them all into one, and we don't really want to go copy, paste, copy, paste. I'm just going to go back here, because you'll see that once we've done that, I've got another folder where I've got the next five divisions. And you'll see why Power Query is so useful with this type of query. So what we want to do is we want quickly to get all those five into the same Power Query. What we can do is go into our Excel file, go to data, go to the get data, and under from file, you'll see an item here called from folder. When I click on it, it needs us to browse to the correct folder. So you'll see we now need to just track down where the folder is. So you'll see that's the one over there. I'm going to say OK. So there's the path. When I say OK, Power Query goes and it looks in that folder. So this is a folder, and it lists every file it finds. Can you see it's division 1, 2, it gives you the file name, what it is, and all information that was sitting in the actual folder. If you're happy with that, we can either combine it directly, we can load it straight back into Excel, but we're going to say edit, because we're going to go into Power Query and see what the options are there. So what you'll see is all it's done at the moment is just listed the file names, so that hasn't really achieved much. But what you can do is you'll see here where it says content, there's a little button here, and if you hover over it, it says combine files. So that's doing exactly what we want it to do. If I click on it, it runs through. And what it's now done, and it gives us a bit of a preview, is it says this is the example file, division 1, and that's what it's going to look like. Are you sure? You're happy that it's a comma, etc. It looks at the first one, and whatever your rules are for the first one, division 1, it assumes you mean for all of them. And obviously they need to line up properly. If we're happy with that, I'm going to say OK. And what you'll see it does is it goes, pulls through all the data, adds one extra column with a source name. So you'll see it says division 1 here. So that's the actual file name that was used to get this data. And if we scroll down here, you'll see eventually, once division 1 is done, then division 2 comes through. So you've now got them all combined in one. So for example, I'm going to go and just close and load it back into our file. And you'll see now you've got it here, and we can go all the way down, and you'll see division 5 gets us to row 1597. Now that we've created that query, we discover that we've now got five more divisions. So you'll see in the actual folders, I'm going to copy these new divisions, just put them into the original folder. Now, do we really want to go through this process again? Don't have to. Now that I've set this query up, all I can do, I'm going to right click on this one. And when I say refresh, can you see it's now captured in all the other information? So without doing anything, it now knows that there's five extra files in that folder. Gonna just go here, let's actually go edit it, so go see what it looks like back in Power Query, and you'll see nothing has been changed. It knew based on the source that it must go to that folder and find whatever's in there. When you refresh, it now sees 10 files, and that immediately updates. Let's now do the opposite. Let's remove these. So I've deleted them. Close this down, go back here, let's refresh it again. It's going, it's running through. You may have noticed there the rows have dropped back to 1596, and that's because it now only records the first 5 divisions.